So number three is exchange. First we said desire, then requirement, now exchange. Money is a means of exchange. Money is a means of exchange. And so you should have something that if you give someone, they give you something back. And that's what life is really all about. We've talked about give and take. Exchange. There is nothing in this life you're gonna get that is just, oh yeah, here, and you did nothing. It goes as far as, I mean, I've watched, there was a video I watched the other day and it was so sad, it really hurt me. And I'm seeing this woman, mostly Nigerian woman, who have been sold out for prostitution. And the people who take them across to these parts of the world, Italy mostly, now I've seen another one in Libya and different parts of the world, they've been taken there. Mostly ignorant, they don't know what they're going there for, and then they get there and hey, that's what you're supposed to be doing, prostitute. And what is prostitution? You exchange your body for some man to sleep with you, and then they give you money. So you see what we mean, exchange? You give something, they give you something. So if in this life we want to grow, we have to start asking ourselves, what can we exchange to get something? I exchange knowledge. So I give you a skill. That skill is definitely going to be useful for you, and so you give me money in return. You walk into the mall, you want to buy banana. Banana will give you some satisfaction at that point in time. So you walk to the person, the cashier, or the you give them money and they give you the banana. And so you want to buy a phone. That's the biggest one. I love to talk about phone because I see these young people, all they want to do is carry the highest technology in phone. And I say to people, that is a business in your hand. iPhone 7, Samsung 7, you name it, they want to buy it. And they pay ridiculous money for it. I would know because my children have it. Against my will, I scream all I like. I'm a mother. You say your bit, but young people, what do they know? And so they pay all this money, the little money they've worked hard for, they give it to this phone company. And so they exchange their money to have the convenience of a phone that maybe they call you and you can talk and you see each other. Maybe that's what they're looking for, because most phones can do most things. But no, young people, even older people, want to buy the highest technology in phone. And then I see them here in my training, and they can't pay for a training, they can't pay for a course that will change their life and better themselves, but they want to buy a phone that is just to say hello to somebody, and the person says hello to you back, and you exchange messages or information or whatever. So you're exchanging something. At every point in time in life, you have to exchange. What you want to do to yourself, which we've said, start with your desire, then you find out what the requirement. Then you start asking yourself, as I'm growing now, what do I hope to exchange to get my desire? What do I need to give to get that thing I'm looking for? I want to go to Japan. What do I need to give anybody that will help me make the money that I need to go to Japan? So remind yourself constantly, what is the means of exchange here? What is the means of exchange? If I have to work, and this is something I say to people, you get people say, oh, I tried to get a job, and then they said to me, I don't have experience. Yes, you hear it every time. And so how do you get experience? So most people will say, but chicken and egg, which one comes first? How do I get experience in order for me to work? And then there's so many ways. First time when I came to England, I was new in England, I knew nobody. I chose to go and work in charity shops. Charity shops. People that don't pay you. Because I had something. I had time. You see what I mean by exchange? We all have something to give at some point in time. I have time. And so I could give my time to gain experience. And that's my advice to young people, especially in Western world. There's so many charity organizations. All you have to do is go to them and say, listen, I've got so much time on my hands, I don't know what to do with it. Could I come and help you out? And so you use your time to give in order to get experience. So that's what it is. If I said to you, I would train you to become great at hair designing, what do I want? What's my exchange? I want money from you. Give me money and then I'll give you that knowledge. You say to me, I haven't got money, but you've got money for other things. So that's what it is. You want to be able to multiply money in your life, you have to give something. I just did a course in filmmaking. I exchanged money for that knowledge. And so whenever you want to change something in your life, be ready to exchange something. Now, this is where it gets tricky as well for some people. I get people saying to me, I have so much bills. And that's especially for us in the Western world. There's too much bills. And one question I always ask people is, will the bills multiply? Will it multiply money for you? Because if you pay bill and pay bill and pay bill, are you getting that money back? No, you're not. You will not get that money back. And the interesting thing about bill is, it never stops. Bill is cumulative. It just keeps amounting and amounting and, you know, adding on and adding on and adding on. So, for instance, your phone, you've got this phone from this network, and they say to you £50 a month. That's £50 a month. Every month, £50 will come. So next thing you're going to go, oh, but I got my phone bill to pay. Yeah, you got that phone bill to pay because you have to pay that bill. £50 was the agreement. But will that £50 grow another £50 for you? No. And this is where you have to think first. Do I really need a phone right now since I don't have a means of income, a steady means of income? Do I need that type of phone? Could there be another phone that I could pay £10 a month instead? Then once I've stabilized myself and I have a source of income that's bringing me £50 every month, for instance, or let's say bringing me £100 every month, then I could do a £50 phone deal if that became your priority. So you need to work with yourself to know what makes sense. What can I exchange in order for me to have what I want? You have to really think long and hard. And once you know what you need to exchange, what you then need to do is work on that. So we're saying, if money was the issue, you want to buy my training and money was the issue, prioritize. Prioritize. Tell yourself, every month I have to put aside $50. I have to put aside $100. And for the next 10 months, I want to put together $1,000, for instance. Or the next 1 year, I want to put together $1,000. Or maybe I'll start with the first one, the small one. And then once I've got that knowledge, I'll use that to make more money. And then I'll put money aside. And then, you know, so that's how you plan it. Don't sit back and tell yourself, I haven't got, and you sit down, do nothing. Doing nothing in life is not an option. Because like I said earlier, we just have a time, a limited time here. And that limited time is up to you what you make of it. It's up to you what you make of it. So if your dream is just to sit back, do nothing, and wait for that time to be over, that's fine. But if you want to relax and enjoy life, which one of the things in the Bible clearly says, I'll see if I can find that passage. It says to you, one of the things you have to do in this world is work hard. You work hard, you share some of it, give it to charity, learn to give people. And then the next thing is, be happy. Just be happy. Rejoice. This is in Ecclesiastes 3, verses 12 to 13. A man should do good in this life, rejoice, work hard, and enjoy the fruit of their labor. So if you feel you've got all the things you're looking for, share some of it and have fun and enjoy. Number four is, what do I exchange? We've discussed that already in the process of discussing exchange. So what do I exchange? Now, when you now become your own person, you want to start sharing things with the world is, what does the world want from me? What is out there that I could give? What are people looking for? So when you start dreaming of making money, which is one of the good things we're talking about here, is what do people want? What do people want? So when we're looking at what people want, there are two major ways to look at it. There's need and there's want. So need is a necessity. People need homes, people need food, people need one of the ones we found out recently is image. Image is everything, people like to say. And that's why when you look at businesses like beauty and hair and fashion, they will continue to be there. Because lots of people sometimes may be hungry. They're hungry, they know food is a necessity. But no, the image is the first thing. I hear people say, but the first thing people see on me is my looks. And so if I haven't eaten for the past 2 days, nobody knows. When they see my face and they see it's looking good, then that's all right, because that shows I'm doing well. So yes, people need image. People need food. People need homes to live in. People need, you know, I find personally that skills, which is one of the things I like to share, people are not desperate for it. And that's again the reason we're talking about this, because skills or information and knowledge, these are the things that makes you grow. There's a Bible passage that clearly made me understand this. It says, above all things, you should gain wisdom. Wisdom is the first thing that God said we should get. Why? Because without knowledge, you're empty. And in whatever field you want to go into, in anything you want to do, the first thing you want to do is gain knowledge, gain wisdom. But I find necessities of life, first thing people want to do is they want to eat. And then of course, where can I sleep? And then of course, oh, my image counts. And so when you start looking at how you want to exchange things with people, you're asking yourself, what do people really want? What can I exchange with people that they can exchange something back with me and that will help me grow? Because it's about you growing. So once you start dreaming, yes, you have your desire, you have your requirement, what do I do to get that? And then you have, what do I exchange? But now you ask yourself, what do people want? What are people looking for? Because remember, you want to get rich quick. So if you want to get rich quick, how do you, what do you give that will give you something back quicker? I know for some of us, that doesn't happen, in the sense of, I want to share skills and I find that people are not really that interested in skills. But that's what helps me as well, because now I know better. If I never tried it, I would not have known. And another Bible passage says, you know, we shouldn't just stick ourselves to the one thing. It says, learn as many things, invest in so many things. It says, invest in 7 or 8. So now you can see me doing different things. I got my fashion line dealing with the African couture, I call it, or African queen. And then I'm into looking at healthy food and how I can help people, you know, develop healthy lives. And I'm looking at image as well. We know about the hair. So there's so many different angles to life. And so when you are thinking and planning, how do I get rich? You have to start thinking like that. What can I exchange with people that will help them help me? What can you give people that people will be appreciative of and they'll be happy to exchange something with you as well? So while you're thinking that, always remember necessities and remember luxury. Because again, depending on who you're dealing with out there, some people just value their luxury more than their necessities. Whichever way works for you, go ahead and think about it. But this is where, again, we're using our mind to start creating the things we're looking for. Okay, so we're carrying on, and we just finished number 4. And I'll just quickly recap on what we've done. So first is your desire, your wish, your dream. You know what you want. Next thing is you're trying to find out how to get what you want, what is required to get what you want. And then the next thing was how to make that happen. So how to make that happen was becoming like, in some cases, I need money to do this thing that I want. I need knowledge to achieve this thing that I'm dreaming. I want to find out what else is required that I can achieve this thing that I want. So that became exchange, or what was, we said how to make it happen, or how to make money happen, and that was the exchange. So what is this thing that I'm exchanging to achieve what I'm looking for? And then what do I need to do to be able to make that happen? So this is still focusing on what you want. And now you know what you want, but you're trying to see what you can do to get what you want. And this is where you are beginning to think, how do I make money? Not in the sense of, okay, initially I'm talking on the general level. Now I'm trying to break it down to specifics. So now we're getting into, how do we make the money happen? Because first, you know, you have a desire and you want to make it happen. And we're looking at desires based on money, not just, there are instances where somebody is in a relationship and is not getting love or attention from their partner. And so that's a different desire. That's not what the desire in this case is about. Or this person has been married and wants to have a child and they're desperately looking for how to have a child. That's a desire. And how do we go about achieving that? So those are different desires. So our desire here is money-based desire. I want to achieve something, but what's holding me back is money. But I want to be able to make money so I can achieve it. And so we know we have a desire. We know we want to exchange something to be able to get what we want. So you now have to break it down to, how do you make money? That's the next thing. And this is where we are now, number 5. You start. You've been able to find out what to exchange. So what to exchange? We're talking about luxury. We're talking about necessities. So we're dealing with human beings now, the public. One big thing you must get from this is, money does not make itself. You have to exchange something to have money. And that's why the message here is to try and educate your mind to start thinking outside of that box of thinking, I don't have to do anything and I'll just have money. I just have to go and defraud someone and make money and, you know, steal some money and make money. No, you have to think. That's why you think and grow rich. You have to think, what can I exchange with people that they will give me money for? And I exchange skills with you so you can pay me money. And people exchange products with you so you can pay the money. So you go into a shop, you buy creams, you want to put it on your skin, you put money down. You buy food, you want to put it in your stomach, you put money down. So generally in the world right now, it's about money. Money buys you things. There's a Bible passage that talks about money like that, which was really, really shocking to me, because I was like, oh wow. Now, generally, people as Christians, we tend to think that, oh, anybody that has money is devil himself. Money only comes if you're doing demonic things. No, you don't have to do demonic things. There are so many passages in the Bible. If you go and read, there's one, Deuteronomy 28 is one of my favorites. You see the amount of blessings that God gives to people who listen to him, who do his will. Because the first thing you have to do is try and listen and hear God. Believe in him. Give him everything that you are, because he created you for a purpose, for a mission. So you have to give him everything, and then he will give you the things that will make you a happy person. And when you, the difference between money that you earn because God has opened your way for you, like in Joseph, like in Abraham, is peace of mind. What you get is peace of mind. But demonic money is money that you don't have peace. And this is where you find people go and steal and defraud their country and defraud other people. You cannot sleep because you've taken from somebody else. Ecclesiastes 10:19, money answered all things. Ecclesiastes 10:19. Okay, so gain know-how. The only way you can gain know-how is through training. And training night requires that you invest money, invest your time. Put something down to get something. One of the laws of nature is you cannot get from where you did not sow. You hear people say, you sow and you reap. Or you reap from where you sow. Lots of people just want to go and reap and they didn't sow anything. And in general life, it's about you gaining knowledge that you require. How do you gain knowledge? People want to just go to people and get knowledge, go online, YouTube, whatever. Oh yeah, I don't have to pay anything, I'll just get it. But you want to use it to get something. How many people do you think really sit down and give you knowledge without you giving anything back? They have needs. They have desires just like you. And they have invested their time and money to be good at something. So what they want to do is share a bit of what they have with you. And I get people asking me, I want to be like that best client of yours. You know that one you train that is so good. But that person gave me money for me to train her. So if you want to be good, you put your money down. What I always ask people is, so would you give me money without any stress like she did so that I can share my knowledge with you? It always makes me laugh. They come, they go, I want to be like this person. I had that person train with you. I want to be exactly like her. But these people came, gave me something. You give and you receive. They gave me something and I gave them something in return, which they are going to go and share with people and get something back. That's how the world goes round. You give, you receive. You give, you receive. You don't stop the buck at any point and say, now I just want to keep receiving, but I won't give anything back. So you want to get rich quick, be willing to give something. You want to give something back to people and then they will give you something. So remember, you have to be in it to win it. If you don't give something, don't expect to get anything out of it. It's like the lottery. Well, that's their slogan. You have to be in it to get it. You have to give, put in something to get something. You don't expect to reap without sowing. And so you know what you want to do, and you've gone, put your money down, you're training it. You get good. And once you get good, you share it as well. And when you share it, you receive back too. So if you've gone to learn how to design hair and work with hair and support hair and grow hair, you're going to go give that to other people. And then they will pay you to. Mediocrity is something I hate. People just want to be in between. They don't want to be good, they don't want to be bad. You see people, they'll come in, they'll say, but I already know how to do hair. And I know you don't. I know you don't. But you just come, I think I know how to do hair because I trained myself. You train yourself and then you say you know. So is it any wonder why people are not coming to you to get their hair done? Is any wonder why maybe they came one day, they're not coming back again? Because you don't have the in-depth understanding of what you're doing. So gain understanding. Bible has told us very clearly, gain understanding. Once you gain understanding, you'll be good at what you do, you will start reaping as well. Because by training, you are investing. When you invest, you receive back. So number 7 is perfect your know-how. So we've said you've gone to take training, you've invested money, you've invested time. Perfect it. Perfect it means use that knowledge over and over and over again. This is one stage where people get confused. This is one stage where people get lost. This is one stage where people give up. I like to call this stage sacrifice. There's a video I'll do on sacrifice. It's one of the biggest things we struggle with. Lots of us think, okay, I put money down and I've got training. I want my money back right now. I spent $3,000 to gain that, to pay for that knowledge. As I come out of that place, I want my money back now. With the first person I see, I want the money back. No, that's not how life works. And that's why you hear people say experience. And that's why nobody sells experience. You can come and I can train you. Yes, I train you in a course. And I can share my experience with you. Being, okay, when clients come, this is how they behave. And I've had an experience where these clients didn't have much hair. And I did this hair in this way. And I have the experience where they will call and they will say they're coming. And then they come late or they don't show up. So I can tell you all those experiences that I had. But I'll show you how to do the hair. That's the training. Now, real life is you have to go and perfect that knowledge. That's real life. Real life is you have to go and use that skill that you got from me. Real life is you have to experience it. You have to work with it. You have to know how to use it. That's experience. And nobody can sell you experience wherever you go. This is why when we started, I said to you, people think, you know, you apply for a job and they say, we can't employ you because you have no experience. And then what I did in that scenario was I went to work with a charity company to gain experience. So I gave them my free time and then they gave me experience of actually working with clients. Of seeing people walk in the shop and leaving and buying things, or of taking a phone call. This was a new experience for me. I'm in a different country. Although I had years and years of experience where I came from, when I moved over, it was like I never worked. So now they want to see proof of where I worked in this country. So charity company became my answer. So for you working with hair, for instance, you don't expect to walk out of training, you recover your money by just the first client you work with. You start working with series of clients. And that's the same across board, whatever it is you're doing. You have to practice it. And that's where you invest sacrifice. Sacrifices. Nobody got anything without sacrificing. And my daughter invested right now, and time she calls me, she says, Mom, it's so hard. And I say to her, yes, because in life, you have to put in something to get something. Now, all the people out there who have not got maybe a degree, you'll be wondering, oh my goodness, I wish I could get a degree. But it takes sacrifice. Sacrifice is the time you sit down and read. To be the best at anything, it takes sacrifice. Sacrifice is the time you actually invest in learning how to work with that thing and use it. I went to Nigeria and I just sacrificed so much of my, what would I say, convenience. Because I know what I'm looking for there. And I don't care how much I sacrifice because I know I will get it. So if you want anything in life and you're not willing to sacrifice, I mean, one of the best things I like to share with people is gold, that gold necklace people wear, gold went through fire before it became gold. So everything in life, you have to be willing to do that thing you don't enjoy doing, that sacrifice, that thing that really annoys you. You know, some people say you sit on they call it getting you off your comfortable couch, because some people just like to just sit in that chair and not stand up, and life answers all their problems. No, you have to get up and deal with real life. And so real life is go and perfect your knowledge. Perfect it. Because now you've decided you want to share this knowledge with people, you want to be the best at the end. That's why I buy books to read. And that's why I take on trainings. So when I want to share things with you, I know what I'm talking about. I'm not talking about something that I have no clue what it is, and then I expect you to believe me. So be willing to sacrifice, and that's perfecting your know-how. So you've done your training, now you know what to do, but you haven't put it into action. So action is that sacrifice. And once you're great at what you're doing, you've got it made. You have got it made. So number 8 is package your know-how. So now you've got all this knowledge, you've experienced it, you know what you're talking about, you're the best at it. Package it. Package it in the sense of, I had an experience once where I wanted to learn how to sew, how to be a seamstress. I mean, I love fashion, you can tell. And I wanted to be so good, I wanted to be the one actually, you know, stitching the clothes, doing it. So I paid money to go and learn it. And this lady that I went to learn from, she was so good in the sense of whatever she's made that I've seen were amazing. And I thought, yeah, she's the person to go and learn from. And I gave her all the money she asked for and the time she said she was going to use to train me. I was excited. And when I got to her, it wasn't anything we imagined. She had not written down anything. She had not packaged this knowledge. She knew what to do, but did not have it packaged. Packaged in the sense of, I always say to people, there's a book that really gives that message. If you can share your knowledge consistently, the same way, get the same result all the time, that's when you know you're good at it. Because, example here, I mean, there are people who they do somebody's hair today, it looks amazing, and tomorrow they do that same hairstyle on another person, it's rubbish, it's not good. And so that tells you that you haven't put it together, you haven't understood what you're doing. So it's a bit like touch and go. Today it might be good and tomorrow it might not be good, so I really don't know what to expect. But when you know you're good is when you can, you know, put that knowledge in such a way that you get the same result consistently at all times. That's when we call you packaged your knowledge. So this is when people then write books. This is when people then write a training program. So if you came to my training, I have it nicely lined out. Today you're doing this because I know what steps you're going to take, and tomorrow you're doing that. And so I consistently train everybody that comes here, same level, without saying, yeah, today when she came, I taught her differently, and tomorrow when another person, no. So putting that knowledge in such a way that the same result comes out is what you want to do. Because then you know you have mastered your knowledge. And that came from sacrifice, because you practiced it over and over and over, and your result now is the same across board. That's what we call packaging your knowledge. And so that's the next stage after you become so good at what you do. You package it. And you share it. Same way all the time with the people you're sharing it with. Same result. So number 9 is market your knowledge or market your know-how. So you've all along you've worked with people, you've know what you're doing, you shared it with as many people as possible, but now we're still aiming at making what we do, we are the best at it, and we want to make so much money out of it. Because remember what we said, when God blesses you, you know, with knowledge and information and all of that, it is for you to grow with it. That's why it's called a blessing. It's for you to spread it out and gain from it. As a Christian, no one ever said anywhere, not in the Bible, did God ever say you should be poor. That's why it bothers me so much. You should be able to market what you know. And it's from marketing what you know that you get money. From sharing what you know that you become rich. And that's why it says, think and grow rich. Because after all that knowledge came to your head and you said, I want to do this, and you've done all your research and you've gone training for it and you've become good at it, you've practiced it, nobody's ever going to sit anywhere and begrudge you because you became rich from it. This is the stage where I know lots of people, going back to Nigeria again, because that's where I come from and because I see so much there, lots of people hold themselves back. I see so many people with so much knowledge they could share, with so much skills they could share. But how to market that knowledge becomes a problem. And so marketing the knowledge, and here in the West, or which again is very available in Africa, things we call social media. This is one of them. You listening to me here. And so anything I have to sell, like I have packaged my knowledge. This is one of my packaged knowledge. I can come here and show you, look, this knowledge is available for you to buy. Go online and buy it. And you will go online and you will buy it. I could say to you, which I am saying now, I have these necklaces. These are pure coral beads, which I have in various colors. You've seen me do, you know, the African fashion, wearing the real traditional outfits, and I wear these real coral beads. They are to me as precious as gold, because these are precious stones. And I say to you, this is it. Go online and buy it. You would know where to go and buy it. And I could put that, I put that on Facebook, and I put that on Instagram, which I will do. I had a video once where I was showing where wigs, we're making the braided wigs, that's coming up soon. And everyone's asking me, where can I buy it? So because I haven't got them in stock yet, I haven't put them up, but it's coming. And so I say to you, go online and buy it. The world has moved on now. Most people go online and buy things. Or if you were located near me, you could come to me and say, I want to buy that dress, that beautiful dress you were wearing. Do you have another one? And so that's marketing. So in the past, the way you market is you buy a magazine page and you pay them X amount and they display your goods for a period. And then people buy the magazine and they read it and they go, oh yeah, look at that beautiful dress. I wish I had that dress. And then your number is there and they contact you. But now there are so many other means. So once you get good at what you do, you market it. So you could go on to, there's pay-per-click as well for Google. There's Facebook advertising. There's Instagram. There's LinkedIn. There's YouTube. And so all these various social media exist. And that's where those phones that people are paying ridiculous money for comes in. But then what I find funny is they buy those phones, pay all that money, they don't use it for business. And so all you're doing is pay money out. But that's besides the point. So you market your know-how. You market your skill. Someone in Africa, in Nigeria, made this beautiful jewelry for me. And I got them for sale. I work with her now, and I've told her whenever I display any of her handwork, I put her information in the description box. And then if you're based there, you can go to her to buy from her. Otherwise, you buy from me here in the UK. Wherever your nearest to is, because you have to consider cost of delivery. And so that's what's happening. So you market your goods, market your knowledge, market whatever it is you want to share with the world. Because the message is you want to exchange it. So I give you this and you give me money. And so the more of this I give out, the more money I receive, the quicker I get rich. Do you see how we've come down to it? So you get rich quick because you've used your mind to create something that people want. You use your mind to dream of something that people need. And so you've been the answer to the question. This is an image question. So this person wants a beautiful image. She wants to be seen out there. So image has been solved. I have other people who have needs of, I want to have a handwork. That's where my training comes in. Answer given. Solution found. So you want to travel, you know where to go, you buy a ticket. You exchange money. So whatever this idea is that you started with turns into a product that then exchanges hands. And once money has been exchanged, the number of times that money exchanges hands is the number of is how much money you make. And that's why you can get rich quick. Because now it's down to you to market your knowledge, to market your skill, to market your product. Okay, so we're gradually getting to the end now, number 10. And I'm gonna say thank you so much for listening to me. And I'm hoping that I've been able to pull something in you that will make you wake up and think. Remember to share this with your friends that are also struggling to trying to make ends meet. Like I always say, when I share this knowledge, it's for me too. I mean, when I look at things like this, sometimes I get so scared. I'm like, okay, because you know they say we have so many spirits that abide in us. But I'm happy that the spirits that walk through me are, you know, God's spirit, because it's there to help people grow and help people become amazing. But sometimes when I share this knowledge with you, it just comes through me. It just comes. And then later I sit back and I listen to myself and I go, yeah, you know, that is so true. That is good. I'm going to do that. But you would have thought that she told us she should be doing it. You'd be surprised that sometimes I need to look at me again to say, yes, you know what you're saying is true. Go and practice it yourself. So my knowledge that I share with you because a spirit comes through me. Spirit of God says, do this. And like I always say to people, I listen to what God tells me to do because I know my mission on this earth is not because of me. It's because God said, go and do it. All of us are here for a, you know, are here on a mission from God. And when I go further into the Bible, it's really amazing. God does not physically walk on this earth anymore. Earlier days in the, you know, in the Bible when Adam and Eve were here, God did come down to chat with them. But now, God talks through us. God walks through us. And that's why it's true that evil exists as well, because the same way God's spirit comes to us and walks with us, the same way evil spirit gets through people and destroy. And remember, what evil comes to do is to kill, steal and destroy, while God comes to build and make better. And so when he uses me to share good things, I listen to when I'm done. I listen. So remember to share this with your friends. So number 10 on our Get Rich Quick is make sure you productize. Productize is a different thing. It's something I learned about a long time ago, about how once you've got knowledge, you take it away from one to one. Very important. Especially for those of us who work one to one with clients. One to one, we're working on hair. You work on hair, and so a client walks in, you work on her hair, you finish, she goes. She gives you money because you gave the time. This is one area again for hair and for one-to-one kind of businesses. I want us to wake up. Think of the amount of time you're going to spend with your client. This is where, especially with braiding, I get really irritated when people want to look at braiding with this lower than low attitude. Oh, is it not just braiding? Now my question is, can you braid? No. Then you hear people go, oh, I sat the whole day in the braider's chair. Do you think that braiding person has nothing to do with her life, that she's standing the whole day doing your hair, sitting on your butt? I find that really irritating, because people should learn to appreciate when somebody is doing something for a good cause. You want an image, she's standing there giving you that image. The least you can do is be grateful. Yes, you're gonna give money, but trust me, if she divides her time by the number of hours you are sitting with her. And that's why you see lots of people who braid hair, they play smart. But okay, my clients, that's a different story. I do not do that, and that's why I charge the kind of money I charge, because either you're willing to pay what I ask for, or don't bother coming to me. Go somewhere else where they will do you 2 hours and give you rubbish. So if someone starts to multiply the number of hours that they're going to spend working on your hair for some money, you get people who want to pay people minimum wage to do their hair. I don't want to quote amount, but it just does my head in. So when you are in that kind of industry where people have absolutely no regard for what you do, and then they want to pay peanuts for your time, it gets to a stage where you have to understand your time matters a lot. Your time means a lot. And I want to wake everybody up from that understanding that there's something wrong with us. Nothing is wrong with anybody. All of us were born complete from God. And this is what this message is about. Whatever has happened, it's in your mind. Whatever's changed you from the other person who's achieving and you are not achieving is down to the way you see things. And that's where your programming came from. And that's where your hypnotizing or hypnotism came from. And that's where brainwashing comes from. People want to look at you and downgrade you and degrade you and make you look small and make you look weak, because it's a mental game. You need to snap out of it and remind yourself that the physical person they're seeing is not your complete self. There's more to you. Your spirit in you is far greater than that physical person they're seeing and trying to downgrade and degrade and make look small and little and stupid. No, wake up. And so productizing is about turning that knowledge you have into a physical product. I know when it comes to working with hair, it is hard to say, I could give my physical products in a DVD and that's it, and I'm making money while I sleep. No, because clients actually physically need someone to work on their hair. But where you could come in is provide videos of your skill and share with the world. And that's where with us, we created this. This is where that training comes in, because then we having people coming from all over the world that cannot travel down here. Obviously the price of just the ticket alone coming down here is more than the price of buying that. Ready. And so all of this is put into consideration when you're looking at productizing. So you create a product that can speak for you, a product that can be wherever in the world without you physically being there. And that's why people write books. This is where my writing books is going to come in. So productize. Turn your knowledge into a product. And when you turn it into a product, you share it with the rest of the world. And this is when things start to change for you. You could be sleeping and somebody's buying your product. That's where we want to be. Making sure that we're no longer physically dragged into every scenario where we have to be there for people or help people. And that's how you get rich quick. So now if you've got all these products out there speaking for you, selling for you without you physically being there, what else is causing your problem? Where is the poverty coming from? Anyway, so it's been really nice sitting out here and chatting with you, as always, from the Joyfido International desk where we inspire you to greatness. Please remember to share this video with as many of your friends as possible. Remember to order your DVD. If you're still thinking twice, we'll talk to you through what you need to do to change your life. That DVD gives you every piece of me. And with that packaged one, what we do is we are physically ready to chat with you. Whatever you're going through, we are here ready to work with you. And then you get a certificate at the end of it all. That certificate you can display in your show to show that you know what you're talking about. I mean, that package DVD set is what more than you physically coming here to work with me. So I look forward to you ordering your DVDs. And I look forward to you sharing this with your friends. And I look forward to you subscribing and looking out to hear more from me. Because like I said, the angle I look at things is completely different from the angle other people look at it. And it's always based on your personal experiences. And my experiences are so unique that I'm more than happy to share them with you as well. So I look forward to seeing you in the next video. And thank you so much for watching. And God bless you.